This is Clarence Hill and Shereen Williams coming to you from quiet Central League Field in Seattle, where the Cowboys had a shocking, eye-opening victory against the Seattle Seahawks, 30-23. No one saw this coming.
No, none of us saw it coming, and I think we talked about it being a statement game, and you were with Jason Garrett when we first locked in the locker room. Mm-hmm. Orlando Scandrick was calling on you. Take that as a statement, Clarence. He was looking for you specifically. So, you know, this was a statement game for them. They think they are good enough to win the NFC, and I think we saw today by winning here, only the second loss in Russell Wilson's career in this stadium, this was huge. You talk about the hangover maybe the Seahawks had from playing Monday night, having to spend the Monday night on the East Coast. You talk about all that all you want. Mm-hmm. This team was impressive today, what the Cowboys did in coming here and winning.
Right, and they didn't just prove anything to us, the local media, who didn't see this coming. Certainly when you've seen 8-8 records forever, you get kind of jaded.
Yeah.
And I've seen 8-8 records since 1997. So I'm jaded. You got to show me. It's not my job to believe you're going to turn anything around. Do it. The Cowboys did this today. They not only showed it to us, they showed it to the rest of the NFL. I mean, this was an eye-opening for the NFL. They let everybody know, put everybody on notice, this Cowboys team is for real. Consider the Cowboys gave them 17 points off of turnovers, special team mistakes, a block punt for a touchdown. Otherwise, they dominated the game statistically on offense and defense.
I'm not sure what was more impressive, whether it was the running game, because we know the Seahawks don't have anybody run on them, and not just DeMarco Murray, but Joseph Randle did it too. I don't know if it's that or if it's the defense and the way they played. And I know the Seahawks aren't the number one offense in the NFL. This isn't Peyton Manning. I understand that it's a different type of offense. You call it kind of a college offense. I understand all that, but this defense was amazing the way they played. That, to me, were the two things. That's why they dominated this game. And if it wasn't for special teams, this is a blowout today. Right.
There's no doubt. And as I've said, and you just mentioned, the play of the defense was as impressive, if not more impressive, than the offense, because of our expectations and, again, our opinions of this defense coming into this game. And we know what they have with Russell Wilson and Marshawn Lynch. Percy Harvin, Cowboys shut them down, shut it all down. Russell Wilson and their little college offense and all that sideways stuff. Marshawn Lynch, beast mode, nothing. Percy Harvin, stuff that Scandrick ate him. Orlando Scandrick set the tone for the secondary. Rolando McClain had a great game inside, set the tone up
Anthony
front.
Anthony Spencer had his best game so far.
He certainly had, but then going to the offense, DeMarco Murray. We talked all week about them lighting his load, taking some of the pressure off of DeMarco Murray. In this game, 29 carries for 115 yards against the number one
defense. Six touches in the receiving game.
Against the number one defense in the league, which had only given up 60 yards a game coming into the and I think the longest run they'd given up was 18 yards. So you had a 25-yard run by Murray, a 38-yard run by Randle. But the Cowboys imposed their will. That's the thing. Offensively, the offensive line, they imposed their will against this team at this place. Yeah. You know, they gave up the turnover. They went down early. This place goes crazy. And just talking to a couple of scouts like Bucky Brooks, that's how they get you, because it becomes a feeding frenzy. They do things. They feed up the crowd. Crowd feeds off of them. The Cowboys didn't blink.
They didn't blink, and I think you have to consider them a contender at this point. But what they've got to do now, in Jason Garrett's favors, let's stack wins. Let's get better today. But that mantra is going to carry them through, because they can't be too sky high. They can't eat the cheese, as Bill Parcells used to say. They have the Giants coming in next week, and now they start these division games before they go to London. So it's a big stretch of games, because we know how the finish looks with all those road games. Mm-hmm. Big stretch of games that they can make hay here and put some distance between them and the rest of the division.
And I'm starting to believe these guys can do it. You know, you talk to them, and Jason talks after the game, after they beat the Saints. It's not about the Saints. It's about us. It's about what we do. We're going to do what we do. Forget, you know, you guys talking about how can you stop them. They got to deal with us. And that's the same thing he talked about today after the game. It's about us. Talking to Jason Whitney before he got on the bus to get ready to go back to the airport, he said that, you know, I asked him, are you excited? Does it get you more excited? Or does it make you put your nose more to the grindstone? And he said, this makes us put our head down even more, because we know what's out there. We know what we have a chance to do. So we're not going to get caught up into this. We're going to even work even harder to make this happen. They have won five games in a row for the first time since 2007 when they started 13-3 and had the disappointing loss to the Giants when they went on and won the Super Bowl. But again, I think the Cowboys feel better about themselves now than they did then. Jerry Jones said after the game, this was Jason Garrett's best moment at his Cowboys, better than when he was backup quarterback of those Super Bowl teams and came out on Thanksgiving Day and had the big game. That says a lot about what he thinks about the way this program's going under Jason Garrett and his hopes for the end of the season.
Every year there's a surprise team in the NFL. Could it be these Dallas Cowboys? For Clarence Hill, I'm Shereen Williams, and we're talking Cowboys.